What is Garbosa's criteria? This is basically the criteria that helps you to diagnose with reasonable specificity MI in patients with pre-existing left bundle branch block. Hi guys, this is Dr. Patil here and I hope your preparation is in the right direction. Now, keeping in continuation with the video series that we started to help you prepare or catapult your preparation towards your NEET SS examination, here is the second video in the series, and in today's series, we're going to talk about Garbosa's criteria. Now, they may not directly ask you to specify the components of Garbosa's criteria, but every now and then you may encounter an MCQ where there is an ECG, where there is a pre-existing LVBB, and you might have to decide whether this patient is actually having a myocardial infarction or not, right? So to tackle those kind of questions, definitely we should know Garbosa's criteria. And you never know, the components of the Garbosa's criteria may be thrown in as true or false statements within an MCQ. They may ask you to pick up which of the following is false regarding MI in pre-existing LVBB. Right. So now, what is Garbosa's criteria? This is basically the criteria that helps you to diagnose with reasonable specificity MI in patients with pre-existing left bundle branch block. So in front of you, you have an ECG. Can anybody tell me whether this is a case of just LVBB or whether there is myocardial infarction? Now look at the lead V1, V2, V3. We do see some kind of ST elevation, right? We do see some degree of ST elevation. Don't you agree with this? We do see some degree of ST elevation, right? So before we talk about this Garbosa's criteria, the first point I want you to remember is that some degree of discordant ST elevation in case of LVBB is normal, is expected. So what do I mean by discordant? The QRS complex and the ST elevation are in opposite direction. In other words, in leads where there is predominant S wave or the QRS complex is predominantly negative, we are seeing ST elevation like we are seeing in this case. Now I assure you that this is an ECG of just LVBB and there is no myocardial infarction. Okay, so the take home point here is that some degree of discordant ST elevation is a norm in patients with LVBB. But whenever there is concordant ST elevation. Now, what do I mean by that? When I say concordant, that means the ST elevation is in the direction of predominant QRS complex. In other words, we are having predominant R waves and not S waves. And the QRS complex is predominantly positive and not negative. So when we see that, that is strongly suggestive of ischemia. Okay, so this is the basic understanding. Now, let us see what Garbosa's criteria talks about. So what Garbosa's criteria talks about is three things, three important points. So if you apply this score and get a score of more than or equal to 3, that is suggestive of MI. That is suggestive of myocardial infarction. Now, the first thing, as I told you, the discordant ST elevation has less value and the concordant ST elevation has a high value when it comes to diagnosis of MI in LVBB. So a concordant ST elevation like you're seeing here, predominantly positive QRS complexes and a concordant ST elevation. So concordant ST elevation of more than or equal to 1 millimeter in more than or equal to 1 lead, patient gets a score of 5 points. Patient gets a score of 5 points. Okay, so as I told you, a score of more than 3 is diagnostic of, with a high specificity, is the diagnostic of myocardial infarction in a case of pre-existing LVBB. So if you see that there are leads with more than 1 millimeter ST elevation, it is almost certain that it is a case of MI. The second thing is about concordant ST depression. Now what do I mean by that? ST depression obviously means the ST segment is going down. So the leads where it could be concordant is where there is predominant S wave. So we are talking about lead V1, V2, V3. So in lead V1, V2, V3, if there is more than or equal to 1 millimeter ST depression in more than or equal to 1 lead, more than or equal to 1 lead, the patient gets a score of 3 points. So even finding this is virtually diagnostic of MI. So you find that there are V1, V2 or V3. There is any lead which has more than 1 millimeter ST depression, it is almost diagnostic of myocardial infarction according to Garbosa's criteria. The third one, the gray area, as I told you, the discordant ST elevation has a less diagnostic utility. And that is the one which actually creates confusion. Right? So according to Sgarbozas, if there is more than 5 millimeter discordant ST elevation, more than 5 millimeter discordant ST elevation, patient gets a score of 2 points. So more than 5 millimeters of discordant ST elevation in more than or equal to 1 lead. Discordant ST elevation in more than or equal to 1 lead, patient gets 2 points. So obviously that means the patient has to satisfy other criteria to be diagnosed as MI when we are talking about discordant ST elevation. So you may get an MCQ where it might ask you, among the following features that are listed, which one has the least specificity for the diagnosis of MI in a case of pre-existing LVBB, and that has to be discordant ST elevation. Concordant ST elevation and concordant ST depression have a very high value. Okay, now let me take you to the ECG that we were talking about and see if it fits into. Do we see any lead with ST elevation other than V1, V2, V3? No, right? So in V1, V2, V3, we are talking about concordant ST elevation. Now, none of these leads actually have a ST elevation of more than 5 millimeter, right? 5 millimeter should have been like this. So none of these have more than 5 millimeters. Straightforward, simple, we are talking about left bundle branch block. Do you find any other criteria being met? Do you see that there is any lead where there is concordant ST elevation or concordant ST depression? I don't see. I know there are ST depressions, but they are discordant ST depressions. They are not concordant ST depressions. Right? So this is a simple ECG of left bundle branch block. Now talking about the next ECG, let us apply this Sgarbozas criteria and see what do we get. Now if you look at this ECG, you will notice that V4, V5 and maybe to some extent V6. Look at these leads. You can clearly see there is a concordant ST elevation definitely more than 1 millimeters, right? Now this is a case of LVBB. You can see the QRS complexes abroad, but we have the evidence to say that there is concordant ST elevation in V4, V5, V6, which is more than 1 millimeter. So according to Sgarbozas, what points we are giving him? This patient is getting a score of 5 points. And 5 points is definitely enough to diagnose MI, because I said more than 3 is diagnostic of MI. We'll also screen the other leads and see if we find anything else supportive of. I do see the lead 2, 3 AVF having ST depression, that is probably the reciprocal changes. And I also see the similar more than 1 millimeter concordant ST elevation in AVL. Right? In AVL. So that means my diagnosis in this ECG is about myocardial infarction in a patient with pre-existing left bundle branch block. Got it? Now let us apply this to another ECG. Now if you look at this ECG, do you notice there is any concordant ST elevation other than, okay, I don't see any lead having concordant ST elevation. Do I see concordant ST depression? No. Wherever I see ST depression, it is discordant ST depression. Do I see discordant ST elevation? Yes. V1 through almost V3, V4 to some extent, I do see concordant ST elevation. Now applying this Sgarbozas criteria, because this is a situation where we need to have more than 5 millimeters of ST elevation. Now if you look at the lead V2, you probably agree with me. I know it is not very clear, but it is definitely 5 millimeters of ST elevation, right? It is definitely 5 millimeters of ST elevation. So with this, what points the patient is getting on Sgarbozas? He is getting 2 points. He is getting 2 points. Does he meet any other criteria? No. There is no concordant ST depression. There is no concordant ST elevation. So inadequate for a definitive diagnosis of MI in this case. Right? We have to rely on further clinical judgments. But if this patient had scored any additional points, we would have been more sure about the diagnosis of myocardial infarction. Now, having understood this, to what extent we are certain when we encounter these findings, it is going to be MI. Okay. So this Sgarbozas criteria has a sensitivity of very poor sensitivity. It has got a high specificity. Its specificity exceeds more than 98%, but when it comes to sensitivity, it is barely 20%. Again, the sensitivity varies according to the components that we are talking about, whether it is concordant ST elevation, depression, or it is discordant ST elevation we are talking about. But in general, the sensitivity does not exceed 20%. So what does that mean? That means we will end up missing those cases of MI which do not fit the criteria, right? When we identify these changes, we are sure that we are dealing with a case of myocardial infarction. But when we don't, we still end up missing 80% of those cases. So to pick up those cases which are usually missed, or in other words, to enhance the sensitivity of this Garbosa's criteria, Dr. Smith modified the criteria. So now we have Smith modified Garbosa's criteria, and this is the one that we should be applying for all practical purposes. So what is the major modification? The concordant ST elevation and concordant ST depression changes are same as these Garbosa's criteria. So the only change is in the third criteria, that is about discordant ST elevation. So she actually put forth an idea of excessively discordant ST elevation, and for that what she says is, when you see a lead where there is more than 1 millimeter ST elevation which is discordant, look at the same complex or the preceding S wave. So if the ST elevation is more than 25% of the depth of the S wave, in other words, the amplitude of S wave is, for example, 10 millimeters, then the ST elevation should be more than 2.5 millimeters. If it is more than 25% of the amplitude of the S wave, then it is diagnostic of MI. And this increases the sensitivity significantly. This increases the sensitivity significantly. So I will just give you an example of one of these leads. Now look at this lead. According to Garbosa, the patient had got 2 points because we did notice that there is some degree of more than 5 millimeter ST elevation in lead V2. Right? But just look at the S wave of these V2. I will just trace it if you are unable to see. I will trace those S waves. Look at the amplitude of the S wave. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Literally 7 small boxes. Literally 7 boxes. So that means it is 35 millimeters in amplitude. So 25% of this 35 millimeters should be more than 8 millimeter. At least. So do we have that? No. So now on this ECG, which we were uncertain whether it is MI based on Garbosa's criteria, I am now certain that this is not myocardial infarction applying Smith modified criteria. Okay. So Smith modified criteria is that we should be applying for all ECGs because it has high specificity, as good or slightly better than the specificity of Garbosa's criteria, and it has significantly higher sensitivity. So I hope that helps. I'll connect to you on another such short video tomorrow. Thank you.